Hello everybody, Reed Duke here. Welcome to another Legacy video. This is part of your Blast from the Past Legacy deck series, and today I've got Miracles. Now, Miracles today doesn't look quite like Miracles did 10 years ago, but I took inspiration from what the most common builds of blue-white or Jeskai control look like in Legacy. They often include Narset, Teferi, and Day's Undoing as sort of like a killing blow that they can make, in addition, of course, to all the best white removal spells and blue permission. But I did want this to sort of ring true nostalgically with the old Miracles deck, so I made sure to include a couple of key hits, including Counterbalance, Counterspell, Predict, Jace, and of course the Miracle cards, Terminus and Entreat the Angels. So I'm going to have some fun playing this through a 5-match Legacy League. I hope you'll stick with me. Before I get to that, I'll tell you that you can find more deep, detailed competitive strategy articles at CFB Pro. That includes Legacy. Our resident Legacy expert is Rich Cali, whose stuff is available for free. But you can also read about all the different formats, many different excellent writers across both the free and the CFB Pro spectrum. This is all part of the larger TCG player subscription. That's only $7 a month. If you are subscribed already, keep your eye out for the CFB Extra newsletter that'll come to your email inbox, and that'll sort of give you your quick hits that you need each week to stay on top of what's going on in competitive Magic. Thanks also to Ultimate Guard for supporting me and my channel. This is the Boulder and Trey deck box, one of their sort of more bread and butter products. The deck boxes are perfect for storing, protecting, transporting your Magic decks for any format. Thank you for listening. Let's get to some matches. So what's to like about a deck like Miracles? For starters, you get Force of Will, which is just really good based on how punishing Legacy has become, how much action there is in the first two turns of the game. The white removal is excellent. Having four Swords to Plowshares and four Prismatic Endings just gives you very, very, very efficient answers to everything. And the mana base is comprised of mostly basic lands, so you are super solid. Don't have to worry about Wasteland, Blood Moon, any of that stuff. In fact, I even have Back to Basics in my own sideboard. Okay, I would like to go first, and let's get to this. I guess this hand is fine. I need a second blue source before I can really do anything meaningful, but basically, like, the five cards on the left all look really, really good to me. One piece of permission-based disruption, one removal spell, two basic lands to get my feet underneath me. Snow-covered Island and Ponder. I'm just going to spell pierce that. Why not? My opponent did take a mulligan as well, so just trading off resources and kind of ensuring that they can't get going is a good thing. Sure. Cauldra complete. So I have not yet found my second blue source, but no worries because I'm not under significant pressure. You're going to Snapcaster your Ponder. I think I probably just Force of Will that. Because if the Snapcaster hits the battlefield, it's going to pressure my Narsets and be very annoying. All right. Right. I'm going to go predict you. naming Flooded Strand. Prismatic Vista. But okay, you have Teferi. I would love to draw a land here, please. Nope. That's not what we were hoping for. So already, just from the first game of this league, you can see how many different ways you can build within the sort of blue-white shell of cards. Go for a Narset first. Yep. Okay, I think I actually like all of these here. So I'm going to draw the island. And I'm going to go for another Narset. So that they were able to do an instant speed prismatic ending there because of the Teferi's plus one. All right, I'm going to go for a counterbalance because they can't spell Pierce right now. All right, we'll see if this Entreat the Angels can do anything. True Name Nemesis. Just so happens I have a 3 on top. And it also just so happens that that 3 can make me... Oh, you can't Miracle against the Time Raveler. That is the first time that's come up for me. Wow. Well, okay then. So I know my top card is Swords to Plowshares. Do I want that to be my top card, or would I rather just draw something right away with the Teferi? I'm worried about Prismatic Ending. I'm going to play the Teferi and just plus. So I did not reveal because I know my top card is Swords to Plowshares, but it does mean I have a nice, good answer to the Stoneforge. And I want to keep the Teferi in a spot where if my opponent just hard casts the Batter Skull, I can always minus three. So I just blind revealed another counterbalance. I don't have a lot of answers to that Jace right now, so that's quite problematic. What I really need is to find Narset, I think. Ponder. Okay, Mystic Sanctuary. Can put Predict on top of my library. Prismatic Ending doesn't do it. But yeah, I guess that's just enough. Just Mystic Sanctuary for the Predict, then Predict the Swords to Plowshares, draw some cool stuff. My opponent could even choose to Fate Seal the Predict away. And by the way, I did not play the other counterbalance because I should have played the other counterbalance for that reason. I was thinking that if I can ever get the Teferi off the battlefield, I may want to pair the counterbalance with the Force of Will, but I should have, of course, seen that Teferi minus three coming. All right, I think I'm just going to concede this one because I can't really get out of this situation. It's getting worse and worse for me. I don't have any clean answers to the Jace before the Pyroblasts come in. But should get better after sideboarding. That's the good news. Don't think I want the blue blasts because there's just not enough targets to make it worthwhile. Probably want to trim on endings and plows. Like, I want enough swords that I don't have to worry about a Stoneforge Mystic. Okay. Yep. I'm just gonna fire these off when I can and try to curve into the Narset. This time they got Batter Skull, so I don't know if that means that they already have Cauldra Complete in hand or that they sideboarded it out. Well, I think I have to take Swords to Plowshares just to sort of not fall behind on the battlefield. Yep, so they had just already drawn the Cauldra Complete. All right, I guess I'm going to pass and swords the germ token. Yeah, so I'm going to draw the swords. The problem is, if I use it on the Stoneforge, then I have the 4/4 Batterskull to contend with. If I use it on the Germ token, they could eventually return the Batterskull and replay it. But I think I'm just still going to use it on the Germ token and then hope to find an answer to the Stoneforge or just get ahead with tempo. So I'm expecting my opponent to have their own Red Blast, but what can I really do besides just try to play Planeswalker? My top card, by the way, is my own copy of Red Elemental Blast, which I can choose to either shuffle away or draw, depending on the situation. It's really bad. I guess it's Teferi. I just have to keep digging. Hey friends, welcome back for match number two with Legacy Miracles. I actually lost the tail end of the recording for match number one, but you could see the writing on the wall there. I lost game two. Falling behind against the Stoneforge Mystic is so punishing, especially when the game is centered around Planeswalkers. And that's one of the things that's great about Stoneforge Mystic is it gives you this very, very narrow window in which to answer it. And if you don't, then you're staring down the barrel of a Cauldre Complete. And it's particularly punishing against people who want to overdo it with like Spell Pierce, Flusterstorm, Red Elemental Blast, Pyroblast type of stuff. And that's what happened to me in game two was I was caught with multiple Red Elemental Blasts and lost to the white creature Stoneforge Mystic. But we're back, ready to get some wins. And that was, effectively a mirror match in terms of being a Jeskai control deck. So, not feeling too down about my strategy, even though I did lose the first one. Now this is what I'm talking about. This is the classic Miracles hand, the Brainstorm and the Terminus. Well, I guess I'm gonna play the Tundra. It's like maybe not ideal if they have Wasteland, but let's not overthink it until I know exactly what's going on in this game. Okay, so it's a Dark Depths deck. Feel like this should be a favorable matchup just because of all the ways to kill Merit Lage at instant speed. Wow, that's a lot of discard spells. Yeah, I mean, nothing to be done about it. Well, I guess I could Force of Will it, but like, no, there's not one of these cards that's worth more than two others, if that makes sense. Don't want to voluntarily turn the Thoughtseize into a Hymn to Torak. Okay, and they took Force of Will anyway. All right, that's something. It's not very effective against Dark Depths specifically because my opponent can win this game without casting any more spells. But at least it's something I can cast. We'll try the blind counterbalance. It's a Narset. So I guess that just means I lose, right? So they just get the Dark Depths, make the creature, they know my hand, they know my top card. Is there anything I could cycle into for free? No, there's no Solitude in my deck, nothing like that. So it looks like I'm going to go down. Game number one. My opponent had a good draw with the triple discard plus fast combo. Okay, so they cast Crop Rotation Response. I counterbalance, revealed Prismatic Ending. So obviously, just died to the Merit Lage. I mean, maybe they juked me there to just reveal an additional card from my deck, but I can't imagine that really impacting the match. Anyway. Go for back to basics. Surgical Extraction, Force of Negation are kind of marginal. Mean, this card is good against a heavy discard hand. It's not really good against their combo for any reason. But looks like I'll probably be on fairly minimal sideboarding. Dress down does very little. All right, so these are the cards that I like. I'll add Spell Pierce, Counterspell. Reclamation, the counterbalances. I am on the play, and at worst, I can pitch them a Force of Will. Sure. one thing I should do is consider sideboarding out Basic Mountain in a matchup like this, where I'm both not bringing in Red Elemental Blast and I don't need to Prismatic Ending for three. I mean, you never know. I guess they could surprise me with Choke or something like that, but I anticipate Prismatic Ending for one being all I need. They mulligan to six, by the way, just to keep stock of what's going on. Yep. Wow, they're just trying to fight through the Force of Wills. It's a pretty tough way to do it. Okay, I mean, that would be ideal if this was a land that produced blue mana. I'd be in great shape right now. It's a lot of discard. I'm going to really try to get at least a 1-1 shark out of the Shark Typhoon, because that can represent a full turn against Merit Liege. I wonder why they keep, like, taking different cards every time. There we go. Speaking of unhelpful lands, Sylvan Scrying. So let's try the counterbalance. It is a back to basics, which does not counter the Sylvan Scrying, but it is excellent for me. It's a very scary card for my opponent to have to contend with. Here's my 1-1 shark. I was very patient with. Slamming this back to basics. Does cut me off from white mana, but I think I have to imagine it's going to do more damage to my opponent than to me. And then you could make an argument like, oh, why don't you play the Teferi first? But My opponent has two lands tapped right now, and they know about the back to basics, so I'm never going to get quite as juicy of a position to play it. For what it's worth, my opponent's life total is not trivial. Like, they took a lot of damage off City of Brass. They have Mana Confluence. They did the Thoughtseize. Well, I definitely want to draw Flooded Strand right now. Then, like, I would love to keep the Ponder on top because of the counterbalance, but I'm more am interested in drawing the Scalding Tarn next turn. So I'm just going to stack the two lands on top. Elvish Spirit Guide. And Abrupt Decay on counterbalance. Counterbalance is down. Oh no, Abrupt Decay on back to basics. That makes more sense. So to recap, top card is Scalding Tarn, below that is Ponder. My opponent plays a spell. I do have the option to crack the Flooded Strand in response. So you're going to play a Vampire Hexmage. Yeah, I think I'm happy enough to crack the Flooded Strand and take a shot with counterbalance. It's Prismatic Ending. So yeah, it seems to me like I should just use this on the Hexmage. Scalding Tarn, top card. Don't think it's worth it to swords that. Although, if I minus the Teferi on it, they'll just kill the Teferi and it will fizzle the ability. I won't draw a card. Maybe I should swords it. Trying to think about like what's the sequence of events where I end up losing this game. It seems tough, right? Because I have all these answers. I have the shark to block for a turn. I'm gonna swords the Hexmage and hope I don't regret this. Here's another thing is I would prefer to swords the Hexmage rather than the Merit Lage, because then they gain 20 life and they're not in trouble anymore. If I draw land, then I can just plus Teferi every turn and have access to instant speed Terminus. One thing to think about is sometimes these decks will play a card like, say, Rite of Consumption that allows them to win with Merit Lage without having to connect in combat, and sort of a way to fight against removal spells. Counterbalance shows Brainstorm. All right, so that's probably going to lock up the game, countering the crop rotation there. Very good. I'm on the board. My deck is capable of winning. So I'm going to cut the mountain in favor of, I think, one of these blue cards. Could also be Surgical Extraction, but Force of Negation. Force of Negation's pretty bad. Can dress down making the Merit Lage lose flying. Can that somehow be helpful in any way? Don't really have any ground blockers. But just two mana cantrip or a pitch to Force of Will, all of that is fine enough. Good hand. And my opponent has Mulligan to five, so feeling like they'll need something pretty special to win this game. Yep. So they're probably going to take the Brainstorm, but I can't protect the Brainstorm anyway, because I'd have to pitch it to Force of Will. Oh, they took Force of Will. All right then. Yep. Sylvan Scrying away. For Thespian Stage. I'm just going to do nothing with the Brainstorm. If you're interested, I've got a whole deep dive on how to use Brainstorm available on CFB Pro. But to summarize the 6,000 word article in one sentence, it's don't rush. Brainstorm gets more powerful the longer the game goes, and especially with this deck, I'm pretty happy to just wait as long as possible and kind of do nothing. So there's Lotus Petal, Thespian Stage that could be representing an end of turn win. Wow, that is unexpected. Okay. So how am I going to handle this? I'm going to brainstorm in response. That is very unexpected. I found Counterspell, but that doesn't do it. So I guess it's going to enter the battlefield. I'm going to Swords. Boo. I'm going to play Back to Basics, which will basically lock my opponent out of the game. Then I just have to manage the Planeswalker with like prismatic endings until I can find. What do I even have to answer this? I did not bring in Blue Elemental Blast. So yeah, like what is my plan against this card? mean, I guess the plan is just to kill Boo a bunch of times in a row and wait to find like Shark Typhoon and treat the angels, something along those lines. Teferi would be okay because then I could start prismatic ending at instant speed. So anyway, what do I not want here? The counter spell is not going to do much. All right, Minsk and Boo against the world, and that is much, much more even of a fight than I would like to admit. Okay, so Shark Typhoon. Yeah, I mean, I think I just want to try to. Okay, so I'm gonna prismatic ending Boo. And let's say I shuffle my library. So now I'm at 12 life. They make another one attack me for 4. Now I'm at 8. Then I prismatic ending Boo and make a 2/2 shark the following turn. Guess that's what I have to do. Definitely got me with their surprise sideboard card here. Man, and they're actually just one Urborg away from being able to combo off. Man, that's two times I've shuffled my library and just drawn the card that I was supposedly shuffled away. So I'm gonna go to 3 and then to 2, make my shark. They're still threatening lethal just with the 4/4 trample. Bojuka Bog, sure. Oh, I didn't think about going for 3 islands and then Mystic Sanctuary. That would have been good. Not that I have any direct outs to the Planeswalker, but I could at least get a Swords to Plowshares. I think one of my best draws here would be like Teferi. Yeah, I'm just dead. That is a discouraging loss. Technically, you get one more turn, but there's nothing I can really do with it. All right, I am soundly defeated. I'll be back for round three. Hey, I'm back for match number three with Legacy Miracles. I'm on the draw with seemingly a pretty good hand. This looks like a good hand to me, but I've been losing when I start with hands like this. Opponent's deep in the tank. Scalding Tarn really does not narrow down the range of legacy decks somebody could be playing with. Right, Scalding Tarn pass. I will play Flooded Strand pass. This does not seem like a hand where I want to go for basic plains, so if I want white mana, I have to probably Tundra. Okay. Though a Dragon's Rage Channeler deck is very likely to have Wasteland, so now I'm going to amend what I just said, and I probably want to just get my mana underneath me with basics for this matchup. So planes, swords to plowshares. Island, ponder. Pretty much just looking for lands. I have found them. So, pretty sure I want to draw Prismatic Vista right now. And then, do I want my next draw step to be the Ponder or the Scalding Tarn? I think just Scalding Tarn, actually. Like with this hand, just making my land drops and playing my Planeswalkers and a big shark and even accessing Mystic Sanctuary. Those all seem like very good things. Play the Narset into open mana. Doesn't sound like it's going to go well for me. So maybe just pass, make a 1-1 shark, or just pass and do nothing. Let's pass and see what the opponent does. My top card is Ponder, which is an above average draw step. So if I could just go a full turn cycle and not crack the Prismatic Vista, that's a fine outcome. Aha! Did not expect this. All right. So now I'll go for the 1-1 shark. Here's Scalding Tarn, Prismatic Ending. Brainstorm in response. Go for it. Force of Will pitching Daze. I'm going to counterspell. Force of Will pitching Stifle. All right. So then it's basically just going to all come down to if I can resolve the Jace next turn. This thing has trample, so there's no chump blocking with shark token. I'm gonna upkeep this. Teferi. Yeah, that should be better. But if I could have done it slightly better, if I had a Tundra, then I could play Teferi, then Mystic Sanctuary, the Swords to Plowshares, then draw into it. But I can't both play Mystic Sanctuary and have two white mana. I think I'll still make that play, Sanctuary for the Swords. Play Teferi. Bounce your Dreadnought. Oh, I could have gone for Counterspell rather than Swords. That's very annoying. Okay. So, probably just going to cut a bunch of the clunkier blue cards. I don't mind Narset. Maybe I'll keep three Narsets. Dress down doesn't, it's not nothing, but it's also not great. Yeah, I think I'll cut dress down. Yep, happy to just do nothing here. Wasteland, good to know about. So top card is Brainstorm, below that Shark Typhoon. You're gonna Surgical Extraction my Ponders. I mean that, I really don't care about that except that it does force me to shuffle my library, so I lose out on the Brainstorm, which would have been nice. This is the end of my turn. You're going to dress down. Sure. The tricky thing is to Pyroblast, I'd have to search for a Volcanic Island, which would then get wastelanded, and I have both no white mana and no blue mana. I do not have a Plateau in my deck. I might get Stifled here, which would be pretty bad. All right. Well, this is not going well. I will finish out the league for the sake of the video, but this is quite a beating. All right, I'm back. Can I get a win? Opponent starts with 6 cards. Yep. So draw the Force of Will, set the island next. Still no white mana. Exploration. I think that usually deserves a Force of Will. If I had white mana for the prismatic ending, it would be different, but I don't. Yep. Mox Diamond discards Urza's Saga, gamble. So this is going to get life from the loam, and then they're off to the races. Discard Crop Rotation. So I'm just going to take Ponder because what I really want is a way to find white mana. Life from Loam targets Verdant Catacombs and Urza's Saga. So I think the move here is I ponder first, because then I can draw my best card and clear the top of my library with the Narset. Yep, so drawing the Scalding Tarn. Then I'll minus. Yep. So I'm going to bounce the Urza's Saga. I could bounce the Mox Diamond, but I don't think that really does much against Life from the Loam. I'd rather just set back the Saga. So their hand right now is Verdant Catacombs, Urza's Saga. They dredge Life from the Loam. They mill Dark Depths. Life from the Lumber Terms, Dark Deaths. You got it. Oh, hello. So I do not have the Narset anymore. All right, I'm going to just pass, and then I don't think I'm going to cast Day's Undoing. I'll basically be deciding whether I want to maximum cycle the Shark Typhoon or like Prismatic Ending the Exploration. So they have one Dark Depths in hand. They're going to go to their draw step and dredge Life from the Loam. They milled Verdant, Grove, and Bojuka Bog. So now I will let them cast Life from the Loam and I'll Prismatic Ending the Exploration in response. So Dark Depths, Verdant Catacombs, Grove of the Burn Willows, Bojuka Bog. Seems like they're probably going to play the Grove. They do have Punishing Fire in the graveyard. Teferi makes so that they can't Punishing Fire at instant speed. So they're kind of choosing between whether they want to do that or just make a token with the Saga. So here I could Day's Undoing in response. Which I guess is a fine play. So the hope would be that they can't find another Life from the Loam. Yeah, Mana Bond, nothing I can do about that. So that's the whole hand. Stage, Saga, Depths, Maze. No Life from the Loam. So in theory, if I can just manage to fight through a Merit Lage and two Urza Sagas, maybe I could win. Yep, you have a Merit Lage. Saga finds Pithing Needle. To name Teferi Time Raveler. So I'm going to start with Swords to Plowshares on the Merit Liege. Okay. So now I'm going to do some fetching at the end of the turn. This is going to get Plains, and then do I want Mystic Sanctuary? Yeah, probably fine to like rebuy the Day's Undoing and then just wait until I find a Narset. I mean, it's also possible I want to just get the swords to manage the saga tokens, but I'll try this approach. Also possible I want a Mystic Sanctuary and then predict myself. These are all lines that are available to me. So Prismatic Ending the Needle. Bounce the Construct. And then I could play a new Teferi in plus, or I could just wait and not play the Planeswalker yet. Because if I plus, I am going to have to chump block the saga, the construct. So I think I'll just go Mountain and attack you for 3. I guess the attack just does absolute nothing against Maze of Ith. Expedition map, okay. So another Thespian stage. There's the Dark Depths. So I guess I'll go ahead and predict myself just to like cycle. Is there anything that I still have 4 of in my deck? Yeah, I guess Ponder and Brainstorm. Like, I'll name Ponder. So Teferi, I'm going to bounce the Construct, then just plan to block Merit Liege if I have to do that. All right, so Narset. That sounds good to me. Then I can either just minus and get the Spell Pierce, which is decent to pair with the Force of Will, or I can shuffle and get a fresh look, which I guess that's what I'll choose to do. And if both my planeswalkers can survive until next turn, then I'll have the Days Undoing plan. All right, so you make Merit Lage, I block, I have Force of Will if you draw a non-land card. So is there anything uncounterable or like a land that ruins my day here? If you draw Punishing Fire, you can cast it twice, but I can counter one of them. All right, I think I'm in good shape. I did not plus Teferi this turn, so I can't instant speed Prismatic Ending. All right, so I guess Brainstorm's fine. Just pondering in case I can find like Jace or something along those lines. Alright, so Swords the Merit Lage. Plus the Teferi. I guess what's the ideal time to do the Days Undoing is the ideal time is draw step, right? So Prismatic Ending here. Prismatic Ending here. Just trying to leave them with as few resources as possible after the Days Undoing. Okay. We've done it. All right, plus. Minus the Narset. I'm looking for Jace the Mind Sculptor or Entreat the Angels. Those are going to be the easiest ways to win. Counterbalance is fine. Brainstorm. I guess I can also hard cast the Shark Typhoon, which is a good play. After all that, my position's just not that great. I mean, it's okay, but I guess it's good enough to draw a concession. All right, head to work for that one. There's nothing super obvious to come in. Force of Negation, back to basics. I guess those are good. Then it's like Meltdown and Stony Silence are good against the Mox Diamonds and the Urza Sagas. Well, Stony Silence is not that great against Urza Saga. So I'll bring in Meltdown for sure. The Blue Blasts are good against Gamble. Surgical Extraction, I guess, should come in. So these are kind of the maybes up here. On the draw, Spell Pierce, Counterspell are kind of marginal. Dress Down's good against those Saga tokens too, so I'll keep that. Okay, so I guess I like these 59 cards Possible exception of the mountain. I could board out the mountain. And then choosing from among these. So Stony Silence is going to stop four Mox Diamonds and one Expedition Map. Elemental Blast, Hydro Blast hits Gamble and Punishing Fire. But I guess Spell Pierce and Counterspell can do that too. I mean, I did just lose the last match or two matches ago outright to Minskin Boo. I don't know if this player is going to have it, but maybe I'll want to have some number of blue elemental blasts just in case. Let's try this. And then for game three, if I'm on the play, I'll certainly bring back the Spell Pierce. Shouldn't be F6 here. That's giving away information. Well, this looks like the classic land start. It's one of everything. Turn one life from the loam off to the races. Yep. It's gonna be tough. So it's just Thespian stage into fetch land. So, oh, they chose to draw a card rather than dredge the life from the loam. Interesting. Yeah, I guess. They going to try to kill me with crop rotation? I guess I should brainstorm. Surgical extraction. So I would love to find out what's going on. The problem is, I am dead right now to crop rotation if my opponent has it. The only thing I could possibly do against crop rotation is surgical extraction myself to shuffle my own library and get a fresh draw step. I don't think I'm going to do that. Okay, so I guess I can predict myself. So, sure, put back. Flooded Strand. Flooded Strand. Then I draw. I play Volcanic Island. I pass. See what my opponent does. And in the upkeep, I'll surgical the life from the loam. Right, they really have nothing going on. Just the pyroblast, and then any surprises that came into the deck after sideboarding. There's no Minskin Boo. Yeah, just a couple pyroblasts. All right, I was gonna be dead if they had crop rotation. But I like my position now. Last zone was the draw. Predict naming Flooded Strand. I've drawn another Surgical Extraction. Now I'm just going to play something that's going to get Pyroblasted, which I guess, well, maybe I start on Brainstorm. Shuffling away Surgical Extraction and second Narset. Prismatic Vista for an island. Play Counterbalance. You can actually kill a lot of my... They can fight through a lot of my stuff with the Blast Zone and potentially even Thespian Stage copying Blast Zone. Ponder. I don't think I care about any of that. I mean, it's not bad to have one Swords of Plowshares to play around a top deck Dark Depths. Yeah, I guess that's fine. Right, so as expected, Thespian Stage copies Blast Zone. So, like, in effect, my opponent can kill my Narset, my Jace, and my Back to Basics. It's going to take me a long time to actually win this. Saga's relevant here. If I had known that was coming, I would have chosen the Meltdown over the Swords of Plowshares. But Swords of Plowshares is fine against Saga as well. Minus. The Teferi is just another thing that's going to get killed by Blast Zone, but maybe that's fine. Not sure if that was right. I mean, it's always like you just have so many choices when you're resolving a Brainstorm with a lot of cards in your hand. And what do you want to keep? What do you want to shuffle away? Looks like I may get to untap with the Mind Sculptor, which is good news. Yep. Nar sets down. So is this actually a good time to play the back to basics? Seems like it is. Yeah, Needle for the Jace, but my top card's Prismatic Ending. I also can remove it with Teferi. All right, Dark Depths, and then this is a Thespian Stage, right? So I just have to make sure to keep white mana open at all times. I think they know about Swords to Plowshares from a previous Narset activation. Also, just I've seen half my library kind of make sense that I would have one. Start Fate Sealing. I should probably bounce the Mox Diamond. Is now at the back to basics. That is one of their more important mana sources. Now it's all over with the crying. You sometimes reach a stage with a deck like this where you kind of stop trying to optimize everything and you just try to get the game over with. Because, of course, it's like I could be brainstorming and activating Narset and trying to do everything perfectly, but that would just be a lot of time off my clock for no meaningful difference in the game. It's good practice, of course, to think about like what could go wrong, how could I lose, and make sure I have all those bases covered, but I just don't think there's anything from here, like with multiple counterspells and multiple swords. Okay, I'm officially on the board, and I'll be back for the fifth and final match. Don't go anywhere. All right. Welcome back to the fifth and final match of today's Legacy League. I'm 1-3, so we're on Operation Don't Embarrass Myself. But I'm on the upswing. I've just started my triumphant comeback. My opponent has taken one mulligan. Ancient Tomb Chalice, so I'll brainstorm in response to that. Yeah, this is all fine. Like, I can Prismatic Ending the Chalice if I need to, but I'm also happy to just curve Counterspell into Narset. Still, a lot of decks could be starting on Ancient Tomb Chalice. I don't know yet exactly how I want to approach the matchup. Looks like it could be like an initiative deck, Cavern Naming Human. I don't think I'm going to be worried about Wasteland necessarily. So that's an uncounterable seasoned Dungeoneer. Interesting. So I guess I'll start with a Narset minus. Take second Narset. Then it's going to be 2 mana to Prismatic Ending the Chalice. Ponder. I think I like everything I'm seeing there. Lost well to Scry 2. So basically what I have to worry about is more uncounterable humans. Like anything my opponent can throw out that I can Force of Will, I really don't mind.
Yeah,
They revealed Simeon Spirit Guide there with the Explorer, and they binned it. Yeah, I'm going to Force of Will, pitching Counterspell. The annoying thing is that they get to recast the uncounterable Dungeoneer and just keep moving further and further through the Undercity. Bounce. Bounce something or just brainstorm. Just bounce the Goblin Shaman. Maybe that's wrong, actually, because I do want to hit a sixth land so I can go Narset and Day's Undoing. I feel like I don't have much plan against the Throne of the Dead 3. So, thinking about ways that I can stay in the game, it might just involve like a natural miracle terminus. Narset minus. So, if I find the terminus, then brainstorm it back. But I need to find another brainstorm, basically. Swords to Plowshares is something. So I guess I just have to Swords the Fury. And maybe I should have kept the Terminus in hand to just cast it for 6 mana. Player. Transition. Man, I mean, there might be a way that I can thread the needle here where like I find some removal or a miracle terminus, then I Day's Undoing and then quickly get another creature out to steal the initiative. But a lot would have to go right. Oh, Entreat the Angels. So you can go to the trap and then hit me with an protection from creatures creature. So maybe my best plan is like entreat for some number of angels and then try to Narset into a Swords to Plowshares. Could also so it's like miracle for three and then hope I have a Swords to Plowshares in my Narset cards or not miracle go with the Day's Undoing plan see more cards for the swords. I guess I'm gonna miracle and just put all my eggs in this basket. Ooh, what about the Mystic Sanctuary? That yeah, this works, this works. I actually am, well, not necessarily dead. I'm still in trouble though because they're gonna cast the Caves of Chaos Adventurer and then copy it. But I can block that one with the Angels. I can't block the Seasoned Dungeoneer. Solitude. Trying here. I'm trying to thread that needle. So let's say they forge onto the Solitude, then they play the Caves of Chaos Adventurer, and they copy it. No, they're actually going to go to the Scry 2. You might be confused. Why do I keep mentioning Caves of Chaos Adventurer? Because that's what they explored into the previous turn. Two top, zero bottom. Yep. So here's another Dungeoneer. Move to the stash, get a treasure. No activation of the reflection just yet. Ooh, Terminus. So I would like to take that initiative, please. Then I'm just going to go for good old 6-mana Terminus. We're going to see what happens after that. So now they get another Throne of the Dead 3. They took back the initiative by copying their Dungeoneer. Looks like they didn't find Fury. They're just going to get another initiative creature. So I probably should have just miracled the Terminus and cast Day's Undoing, because then I would have more mana available to me at least. Chalice 3? Wow. Chalice 3 is a good play. I wonder if this game was winnable for me. So if I just miracled Terminus, then played Day's Undoing, then, I mean, who knows? I'd have a fresh hand. They do have the Chalice 1, though, which takes away my best card. They would, of course, still have the initiative. Shark Typhoon. I think I'm just dead, regardless of what they target here. So I have to make a big shark and block the Caves of Chaos Adventurer, but it does have Trample. Is there any instant that I can draw right now? I guess I can miracle a Terminus. That's what could happen. All right. Well, that was a wild game. That was only game one. After sideboarding, I guess I just want everything that kills a creature. Containment Priest can, in theory, steal the initiative. That might just be good enough to bring in. Counterbalance is very bad. I don't mind the counterspell and the spell pierce when I'm on the play. What about this mountain? Yeah, let's do this. So, I mean, lands in a force of will. I guess that's good enough. I also have some draws that would make this a really good hand, like if I draw Brainstorm. I will force of will that. Now I desperately need a brainstorm. All right, that one works. Discard Simeon Spirit Guide, stuck with the other two. This thing gets to attack uncontested, which gives them treasure. Archon of Emiria. Okay, so I'm going to fetch a Tundra in response. Maybe a Tundra and a Volk. Prismatic Ending, I guess better late than never. So I'm going to hit the Goblin Shaman, and then the question is, do I want to put it right back on top of my library with the Mystic Sanctuary? I think the answer is no. So I'm just going to go Plains Ending. I need Brainstorm. Brainstorm saves this game for me. Oh, When it enters the battlefield untapped, you put something on top, but this makes it so that lands can't enter untapped. So that's interesting. Probably just want to Swords the Reflection and playing this tapped, I guess, is fine. I think I'd rather draw just about anything besides, well, not just about anything, but like a thing of land would be a better draw than a Swords to Plowshares. Blue Elemental Blast. That is not a better draw than a Swords to Plowshares. Fury. All right. Well, if I draw a land, Terminus is a good play. They do not have the initiative yet. If I don't draw a land, I can at least blue blast the Fury. Brainstorm. Wow. Okay, that's fine. Kill the Fury, live to fight another turn. Now, I'm going to miracle the Terminus. Do I use it or just wait? I think I should use it. No. All right, uncounterable Archon. Prismatic Ending. Might as well. That is counterable, but it's not spell pierceable. So now I'm in big trouble. Now I need a big draw step immediately. Well, that thing just kills me in one hit, so I guess that's pretty obvious. Ah, but they're not going the trap direction. Simian Spirit Guide, all right. Jace. Okay. This is sort of a plan. Draw the Shark Typhoon next turn. So they're going to get to go to like Stash and then Catacombs. If the Jace survives, then I can bounce the skeleton token and retake the initiative with the Shark Typhoon. Maybe edge this one out. What do they do with the scry, by the way? Two bottom, all right. Funny, it's goated, so it can't attack the Jace. Just gonna brainstorm again. So funny enough, the Spell Pierce is my worst card, which might mean that I want it in my hand for the Force of Will. Yeah, so I guess I want to keep like four Spell Pierce, Shark Typhoon. Put Counterspell and Ponder back, something like that. Should be in good shape against anything besides like an uncounterable scary creature. So they would have to have Cavern plus something scary in hand, which I don't think is the case. Archives. Yep, draw your card. Could see doing this for only three, but I'm just going to do it for four. Oh no. Oh no. So now, if they Throne of the Dead 3 into Fury or Solitude to kill my shark, then it's bad for me. Yup, Solitude. Well. Just brainstorm again. Teferi bounce this, Swords the Solitude. Guess I'm hanging in there. And shuffle away my counter spells. Narset. So Narset, Fairy, Swords. Play the Narset first. Oh no, I'm actually one mana short of doing everything that I want to do. All right, so that's fine. Hydro Blast that. Ooh, a Terminus. That is good, right? That is good. So then Brainstorm. Shuffle. Narset. Minus two. Finding Ponder, I think. Plus Teferi, so I can Ponder at instant speed. And yep. I'm at one, so that means I can't Force of Will, actually. Pretty scary. Sure. Okay, Containment Priest. So here's a plus. Here's a minus. Brainstorm. Cast the Brainstorm. Put these two lands back. Bounce. Oh, I think we might have done it. This is still only game two. I can't counter humans or archons. I can counter that. So I think bounce with the Jace. Bounce with the Jace. Plus. Containment Priest actually stops Throne of the Dead 3, which is interesting. Lost Well. Okay, so you get back the initiative. You get the Throne of the Dead 3, but my Containment Priest is going to stop that from doing anything. Then I'm going to instant speed Supreme Verdict and make a Shark end of turn. Yeah, so you see Archon of Emiria just got straight up exiled there. You can have anything that's not uncounterable. But I need to play really fast because I need to win this game and then also have some time. Yes. Okay. Wow, still fighting. Can I win this last one in such a short amount of time? Probably can't sit on spell pierce and counterspell. All right, I don't know if I'm going to be able to finish in time, but let's do what we can. I'm gonna keep this, even though it doesn't have force of will. Yeah, should I keep this? Maybe I should mulligan. Looking for a Swords to Plowshares or a force of will or a force of negation. Just like I'm gonna make no meaningful play in the first two turns of the game. This has got to be better. Swords to Plowshares, Containment Priest. Scry 2, one top, one bottom. Yep, Archon of Emyria. So I think I'm just gonna plow that and play my land. Stash, you have a treasure. I'm going to try to steal back the initiative with my Containment Priest. Containment Priest doesn't stop tokens, so no need to flash it in there. My top card right now is a Force of Negation, which is not great, but I think I'm gonna draw and try to get the perfect brainstorm.
Sometimes like it's not in the department.
All right, let's see. Archon of Emyria, that's fine. Forge. Brainstorm. So maybe I just no, the Throne of the Dead 3 we remember is not scary because I have the Containment Priest. That's actually that's been like a really big deal. So now my top card is Ponder, which is a good card to draw. I think I'm gonna just do nothing and try to ambush with a 3/3 shark next turn. Trap. Man, this is tight, both in terms of like the strategy and the clock. But if this ambush with the Shark Typhoon works, I think I will win. Yes. All right, so I salvaged that by winning the last two matches. Let's have a look at the deck and talk about like what went right, what went wrong. I'd say there's a lot more of what went wrong than what went right. Okay, so first of all, I had a bad league. I went 2-3. Does that mean that this deck has no potential? No. There's a lot of factors that go into determining the outcome of a match of Magic. So it's easy to think like, all right, if you turn the dials like 10% tighter play, 10% tighter deck list, 10% better luck, like maybe I'm going 4-1 instead of 2-3 under those conditions. I did think that this deck felt overly reactive for Legacy right now. Like I didn't have a lot of ways that I could get an easy win or pressure a Planeswalker or steal the initiative. And also, I don't have the best forms of card advantage, like there's no expressive iteration available anymore. So, you know, you're not necessarily making things easy on yourself by choosing a deck like this. Having no outs to Minskin Boo was a big problem, although for a lot of mashups where you face that card, you would know to bring in your Hydro Blasts, and I got surprised by it out of a black-green deck. Having no real plan against an uncounterable initiative creature is also a big deal. Like normally a deck like this should be great against creatures because you have all the white removal and board sweepers and dress down. But if they just take the initiative and you can't take it back, like those games are really, really hard. So if I was to play a deck like this again, I think I would choose one of the versions that has creatures, you know, some combination of Staff of the Storyteller and Stoneforge Mystic. But I still do really like the blue-white or Jeskai Control shell in Legacy. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time here on channelfireball.com.